Oh!
Hey! Hey, it's a fish. It's a bluegill. Slapping me in the face, bluegill. Be slapping me. Look how red the belly is. Isn't that something? Beautiful. Hey, mister. Look, you're in the weeds. Look, go ahead. Bye-bye. Swim away. Swim away. He's gone. He's gone out the back door. Swing it. Swing it. Swing it over there. Oh, excuse me. Trying to do a show over here. You mind? Try coming on cue next time. Thanks, Fred. Gulp waxworm. They call them gulp waxies. Just like little maggots. Ew, maggot. Yes, very good bait. Very, very good bait. Not so shabby. Don't say so. This little jar, I've caught maybe close to 100 fish on so far in the past month. One jar gulp, magic bait. Why is it magic? I don't know. Don't know. They're biodegradable, which means they degrade in the biosphere, which is good because you don't want them not degrading. Eventually, they'll degrade. So for now, we'll be using them until they degrade in the biodome thing. Ask yourself, why? Waxworm, waxworm, catch me fish. Waxworm, waxworm, fill my dish. Oh my goodness, oh, it's a keeper. It's a beast from the bottom of the lagoon. Aye, it's a bluegill. Wow, that one's a bull. Let me show you the forehead on this little sucker. Oh boy, did you eat my bait, didn't you? Oh my goodness gracious. Oops. We're gonna have to get the D-hooker. 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 Come on, Mr. Fish, let's get the D-hooker on you. Let's D-hook you. Alright, we gotta open up the trap here. I know, buddy. No weights. No sinkers. Oh well. Oh well. No big deal. No big deal. Ew, this salad on there. That won't work. Gotta get the salad off. Otherwise they won't bite. Oh, big fish, big fish, big fish. More salad. Boom, boom. Michio Kaku. Oh, bad. There you go. Hey, boink. Ooh, ooh. Hey, Marlin. Uh-oh. Ah. Bye-bye. Chopstick, hook. Very good. You're welcome. Boink. Ooh. Waxworms. Oops. Okay, which way are you going? Boink. Oh, mama. Harpin, where's Moby? Moby, bring yourself before me, you great white catfish. Aye, it's the pink whale. Oh, chip. Shh. It'll hear us. Hey, got me myself in a jam. I lost all me mats. Hey, fish be abounding. Arr, matey. Arr. Abast ye. squatting by the side of the bay. I'll be squatting on the side of the bay. Hey, squatting till the fish come play. Oh. I wonder if it's, is it raining out? Oh. Is that a fish? I think it's raining. I don't think the heavy stuff's gonna come down for quite some time now. I'd keep playing. I think I need to get some of that seaweed off there. It's the weed from the sea! It's no good for either you nor me. Break out your mower and take out the grass off your lure. You don't want grass on the lure. Fish don't want to eat that shit. Shite. If you have children that be watching, make sure you tell them it's R-rated show. The show's R-rated. Parents beware. I use words like sharsh and fart and sarsh. Tangles bound my compares. Oh, look at that one. We can pull it. We can make it work. We get it ranked. Don't let it settle in. See, if you catch yourself a tangle such, but be using all me powers not to have it. Oh boy. Well, it looks like I'll be retying. Back! I'm back with the new hook on the line. I had to retie. You're better off retying yourself. Otherwise, with all of the knotting and confusing stuff you'll be having, you'll be hating fishing it all together. So I recommend, if you have a wee knot in there, retie. It'll take you less than 5 minutes if you're apt at tying. I'll show you some knots that'll make it real quick for you. This way your life will be made easy, not hard. Nobody needs a harder way about them, says Frank. Oh, it seems the fish is on the hook. Oh, my own. Hey. Please stop flapping. See, the good thing about long shank hooks is you grab the hook and you get more control over the fish. And I take the barbs off the hook and we have little sunfish. She's pretty. Very nice fish. Put you over there into the other yonder, wild blue and such. Okay, now pull out the tarn. See, I'll show you how we go ahead and put our maggots on the hook since there's none left. Trick. Leave a little tag end right there. I'll show you why. I'll be giving you the answers why. What was that? Did you hear that, my friends? Sounds like someone be there in the house. Don't know again. Not quite sure. Anyway, what you'll be doing is you're taking a maggot here. You kind of string it on the hook first. You want to get it all the way, like strong on the hook, just like such. Pull her up above, and you see that knot right there? It'll keep her from falling back down, a little bit of tug. Oh, I hear people's coming. I have to be quiet, because I'm in someone else's yard. I don't want to cause any ruckus. Anyway, what we do is we put our hooks, put our bait on there, and you can string them right up the line. There's no toothy critters here. Let's go ahead and put some hook like this. And we make it look like it's a long worm. And then we put a little tiny piece at the end. Just to kind of make it wiggle. Just like this. See? You have a nice, what looks like a more of a bigger worm. It's got a bigger profile. But then when they get close, all they see is little mats. They know it's just little, but then they eat it all. Because it's a meal for them. You see? A meal. I brought myself a rag. I don't know what to do. Done with it. Oh, there it is. Hand wipes are good when you need to wipe your hands. It's very difficult fishing with no weight on the hook. I'll cast that further so it has more time to sink. Hello, mosquito. I see you buzzing about me. Oh, what was that out there? Was that some kind of Loch Ness creature? I hope so. Oh, but she bites on the hook then. Maybe we'll find out what it was. I wonder if it's going to start raining soon. It doesn't look like it. Usually the fish be hitting things on the fall. So as she's falling down, watch your line as she goes. Any kind of tick in the line shall prove a bite from a fish. Generally the line direction shall change, for they feel no weight. And they just swim off with bait. They do not feel pain of the hook, so the hook can be set. As long as there's no tension in line, the fish will never know it. So they do not feel pain. They'll know it when they go in one direction and they can't. That's one thing they say, hey, this doesn't seem right, man. That's the fish fighting. Not because it has a hook and says, ouch. It doesn't know ouch. Have you ever seen a fish swim around only half a body, man? These things happen. This is science. Fish don't feel pain. They can swim with half a body bitten off of them. I've caught fish. Oop, there's a fish. Ooh, whoa, hey. Yeah, oh. All right. Oop, sorry, Bubba. Like I said, if you could get down to the hook, you can get a better grip on him, and he's not going to swing around so much and hurt himself and you. Oops, sorry. It's out. Nice little bluegill. You can see it's a different one. Belly's not so red. Oh, come here, son. Come on. Hey. Ow! I got a spine. They do have spines. I'm going to show you where they are. Ow! As I pull them out of my hands. You can see he's got them protruding right now. Right there. And right at the bottom here. Those right there will get you. So just be careful when you're dealing with sunfish. They have little spines. Let's see if I have any bait on the hook. Nope, the bait's gone. Again, I'll show you how we do that. We just tie on a new one. So I use like a number, I think that's a number 12 hook or a 10. Very, very tiny freshwater hook. And I use bronze freshwater hooks, even in salt water, because they rust out of the fish quickly. This thing will rust in salt water in a matter of a day. You will have no hook left. And if you leave a little bit of water in this tackle box, these hooks, once you use them once, they're gone. They're done. They turn to powder almost because of the metal that they're using to make them. So here, we're just going to put two on there. It's just like a tiny morsel, okay? And just, you know, I lob it out there because by the time it swings down, it's actually right in front of me. So it actually covers the entire water column the way down on a 45 degree angle almost. So you're covering a lot of water. Oop, like that. See? Boom. You just let it fall again. Let it fall. They'll hit it right in the fall as soon as it gets up 2 feet down approximately. Right below where the sunlight can actually penetrate. A little shadow zone. And in that shadow zone is where you're going to find most of your predators. They wade under there. And they could literally be wading in open water right under the shadow lines. Very interesting place to fish when you fish shadow lines on piers. Oh boy, will you find some excitement there. Any type of light in the water with shadow is fantastic fishing. You'll have no problem catching a fish that way. Like I said, where there's little fish, there's big fish. Where there's birds, there's fish. Where there's big fish, there's little fish. Where there's all fish, there's fish. Fish. Fish, birds, fish, people. Is that a formula for something? No. No, I wouldn't even use that on a test. Don't quote me. Fish, people, fish, bird. You'll find one, you'll find the other. All I'm doing is, like, because there's no weight and, the raindrops make it feel like a bite. I want it to be moving a little bit, and every time you move it with no weight on it, it just moves like 80 feet. So I have to be really gentle. It's very finesse type fishing. Let's go over there. because I seem to have disturbed everybody over here. Some of these bigger bluegill will be territorial, so unless you're chumming the area, you have to cast different spots. No big deal. If you throw a lot of breadcrumbs out there or something, you'll get them all in the same area feeding. But other than that, you'll have to kind of move around and find their little home. They'll usually take root inside of bass nests, where largemouth bass and spotted bass nest. They lay their eggs in these sand nests that they scratch away all the spider. They scratch away all of the grass, and they make these little sand pits. And they protect their babies inside there. It's like a little fort. Really, it's kind of cute, actually. Let me get some more on there, make it a little juicier. It's kind of neat. And then these bluegill come and they'll eat the bass eggs. They'll take over the bass nest. They'll come in a fury, so many of them. The mother bass will go somewhere else to lay her eggs. Spiders all over me. Must be a mom somewhere laying eggs. Probably on my head. I don't mind spiders anymore after having had about 1,000 of them crawling across my feet one day. Yeah, with shorts on. Me and Logan were at the ranch, and we were exploring some spots underneath the trees, some hammocks, you know, like under there. And we didn't there was a lot of water. The water was high. It was about a foot of water out at everywhere you go out there. And it was bad. It was like you couldn't walk anywhere. So we went into these areas where you could walk. But sure enough, you're covered in spiders in a matter of minutes. And I ran out, and the spiders just engulfed my feet. And then as I was running through the water, they were just leaping from me, like off my legs. Oh, my God. It was right Indiana Jones moment. And I'm terrified of spiders, you know. And that cured that right away. No problem now with spiders. I'm Spider-Man now. Listen, when you have thousands of them on your feet, holy Moses, unless you keep your calm and cool, you'll go absolutely insane, like just cuckoo, and like run off a cliff. It was terrifying, I'll be honest with you. I'm not scared of much, but spiders do it to me. Not like I said, not anymore. I'm over it now. It's the aversion therapy thing, or whatever they call it, or anti-aversion. I am much easier with spiders now. I look out for them, actually try to help them in the house. I give them a corner to live. I have no problem with that. Spiders are cool, actually, but they're creepy. I just don't want them crawling on me. That's the thing. I don't like stuff crawling. It's like the crawlies, man. They just don't make me happy. I don't mind ladybugs, you know? Sure. Or like monkeys are fun, you know? It's just these things that look so alien to us. Those are the things you really don't want upon you. Or maybe you do. I'm not, you know, just not making a judgment. Not me, though. No spiders, please. But I am not afraid of them anymore. Like that got over quick when I looked down and saw what I saw. It was something out of a movie. There's as many spiders on me as there is raindrops in a 100 yards of this water. It's creepy, man. Oh, shucks. Come on, baby. Am I recording? I don't think so. Oh yeah, okay, I am. Sorry for that abrupt jar. I'm trying to make sure my camera's not wet either. As you can tell, it is raining. Make sure my lens is dry. Sorry. All right, let's move down the bank, down the river, Thames here. Move on down Thames, ready? Move on down Thames. Yeah, okay, Frank. That's that chemtrail's getting to me, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? No lie, I really don't like being out in this rain. But whatever, I want to fish. Sorry, got fish. All I'm doing is just popping. Ooh. Remember, when you, maggots don't travel fast and far, they'll just twitch in the water. So I mean, the slightest of line movement will make that little weightless thing just go crazy, and that's all it needs. It just needs to look like a drowning worm, and something will eat it. Worms don't normally swim out there, so when they are out there, a bird usually dropped it or something like that. Gotta move this hat a little more forward so you don't get I'll use my camera. Ooh, that was a bigger fish than normal. Maybe he'll come back, we'll see. There's somebody out there. Let's fix this a little bit. Let's fix that. Get this back out there. You know, birds will often drop stuff in the water and the fish will eat it. The fish will eat the bird poop. You know, they don't care. They'll eat anything. But they are ready for stuff that falls in water. That's kind of like priority for them. Like, they'll eat anything. So if the fish falls in the water, they will investigate. And if it's a worm, they have no idea about science. They don't know where the worm come from. They know if there's a worm there, they're going to eat it. You know what I mean? They're not saying, oh, that came from Walmart. It's a worm is a worm to them, and it doesn't matter where it comes from. As long as they see it, they're going to eat it. Oh, the mosquitoes want to eat my ear. I didn't bring any of my beautyberry stuff with me. Ow. See that structure? Watch. 90-10 rule, I'll teach it every time I go fishing. 90% of the fish, 10% of the water. So along this river bank here, 90% of the fish are gonna be in 10% of the bank, which is usually the side, the coastline. You know, the majority of water is out there. There's a volume of water which is included in this equation that you have to think about. If it's 6 feet, that's a lot of water out there. That's the 90%, this is the 10% on the shoreline. And that right there is where all the fish live. They live near shoreline. You'll get 10% of the fish out there, but you want 90% of fish. Don't you? I mean, I would, sort of. You know, like I said, I don't know if it's gonna rain soon or not, but we're gonna try fish. We'll try. Here, what we're gonna do, take these nasties off, and I'm gonna turn with these. I'm just gonna take these old ones off. Don't waste them. Throw them out there. The fish will eat them, and there's no problem with the fish eating them because they're actually made of fish goo or some kind of fish enjoyable, fish loving thing here. They're made of fish. Oh, there's an ant inside of there. Here. Go ahead, ant. Find another place to play. We don't need to kill you. We gotta relocate you. Sorry, Mr. Ant, but you gotta be relocated. These are impregnated with a flavor, so you do want to put some freshies on every once in a while, because after a while they just smell like water and they don't stand out. Listen, in fishing you can have something. You have to contend with things that already stand out in nature that the fish want to eat, like things that are hurt or wounded and smell or whatever, and the fish are already on those things. So you have to mimic that, and the way to mimic that is by all the same things, smell, sight, and sound. So you can have lures that pop on the surface and make a clunking sound. All the goodies, you know, just work all senses of the fish. Some days they're responding to more than one sense. You know how you and I are about certain things. Some days we want a movie, some days we want music. The fish are the same way. Some day they're really excited about stuff on the surface making noise. That's one of those things that's really kind of cool. Work the other side of this and deeper out. There on the right of it, now it seems like a better spot. What that is a pump that goes into there and it's pumping water, probably for lawn, for doing lawn stuff, you know, which is a good thing to do. Of course, it's disallowed, but that makes no sense that it would be disallowed because it's the smartest idea. You take water out of here and use it for your grass, it goes right back to here. That's called sustainability, folks. That's the true sustainability, not what they want to offer you from the UN. Sustainability is when you take water from here that goes in your grass that goes right back in there. That's how that works. Just to tell your kids that one. Teach your children well. Teach them stuff and let them fish. Oh, do 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 do. We're gonna sneak through a yard, get over here, and we're gonna get over here to the corner. Nobody's looking. No, don't look up, and nobody will see you. You're invisible right now, Frank. You're invisible. Just keep going. You're invisible. Okay. Whew, that was close. Did you see that? I'm invisible. Ready? Let's catch a fish. Uh-oh. What's that? Is that a fish? That's a fish, folks. That's a bigger bluegill. Oh, my goodness. Look at the size of that sucker, huh? Holy cow. Wow, look at the size of that fish. Well, we're gonna use my fish dehooker on him. There it goes. There he is. Nice bluegill, huh? Largemouth bass over there. Let's try that again. Let's see. Right here. Can I record? Yep. I keep forgetting I have a hand wipe. Don't wipe on the pants, Frank. Wipe on the wipe. 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 Alrighty. Let's try a little bit to the left over here around this tree. A little curveball. Don't mind me, fish. I'm just a tree with a fishing rod. This is camouflage, see folks? Camouflage. I recommend camouflaging yourself when you fish, to be honest with you, because the fish can see you very well. Bass, for example, have an extremely good eyesight in and out of water. They can see out of this water and see me up here. I don't know what that was. It might have just been a pleco, armored catfish. Lots of them here. I caught one on one episode. Overhand cast here. Nice, that's where I want it, right out there. Just let it sink, just give it a second, you know, let the line do its thing. As it's going down, it's fluttering through the current, it's making enough movement, you don't have to move it too much. When it stops, just give it some time, because the fish will have investigated it, and if they don't bite it in a couple seconds, just give it a tiny little tick like that, and that little movement might really, might get you a strike like that. anyway, try it again. Same spot. By the time it actually falls, it's in that spot, maybe 2 feet in front of me. It doesn't fall straight down right now because there's weight on it. It's kind of falling on an angle. Ooh, a fish already tried to take it, a little tiny one on the surface. So they're hitting it on scent also as well sight. This is an impregnated flavored lure. Because it's salt impregnated, the hook is the only weight that's going to pull these down. They kind of would stay neutrally buoyant in the water. If they're off the hook, they'll just sit there on the surface and float basically right below it. That's the good thing about salt impregnated lures. They look like real fish, or they act like real fish do. Let's put it that way. Gotta stop doing that, Frank. Okay.